Joining us now from the Perth studio is Mel Palancian from Red River Resources. Mel, great to make your acquaintance. Red River is a company we've been following for quite some time here at Proactive, but it's the first time I've got you in for an interview. So would you start us off, please, with an intro to the company, to the team?
Thank you, Danielle. It's a pleasure to be here. So Red River is really all about mining copper, lead and zinc in Queensland in Australia. We started production in September 2017, and really the business has been going from strength to strength since then. We've had, you know, the last three or four quarters have been record production at Thalanga. And yeah, we're really about producing as much copper, lead and zinc concentrate as we can, and also growing the business and adding more mines to the portfolio and growing our resources and reserves.
You were telling me before we hit record that you see the team as being the unique selling point of Red River. Will you tell us a bit about this?
Sure. Really from the board down, the Red River team is made up of operators. So we've all worked for much larger companies in the past, and we've pretty much done what we're doing before, so it's not really unique. Most of us have been in the industry for 20 to 30 years each, and we've all got a unique skill set in operations, whether it's in geology or mining engineering or finance or metallurgy. That's really the uniqueness of Red River is, you know, we've done all this before and we've seen it all before, and really now we've gone out on our own in Red River and we're delivering it ourselves.
And now let's take a deep dive into that asset portfolio. You've mentioned already Thalanga putting out record production quarter on quarter. Tell us about this asset and indeed the rest of the projects you have surrounding it, how they all come together.
Sure. So really our first underground mine was West 45, and that's been in production since the beginning, and it's the current mill feed. That's been going really well. We've found additional resources and mine life there. So that was originally supposed to stop in January this year, but it's we've managed to extend the mine life there until the latter half of this calendar year. But also we've started developing our second mine called Far West. And in the past few weeks, we've mined about 3,500 tonnes of development ore out of Far West, and we've processed that now. And that's shaping up to be a really good long life mine. So that's got a mine life of 7 years, but it is also still open at depth and on long strike. So for me, I'm really looking forward to get Far West into production, and we will have two mines feeding the mill. Post that, we do have Waterloo, which is another resource that we have, which we're working on. It's currently in the planning stages and hoping that that'll be our third mine. And then Liontown coming in after that. And we've also got a very large, about 660 square kilometres of exploration tenements in the Mt Windsor volcanics, which have been really, really prospective for base metal ore bodies in the past. So. And it hasn't seen a lot of drilling in the last 20 years. So that's what we're looking forward to, is growing our portfolio organically and making Thalanga bigger and better.
With regards to those more developed assets, Waterloo and Liontown, for instance, will you be using the same mill and infrastructure that you're currently using for Far West and 45?
Yes, absolutely. So we want to really maximise the value of that infrastructure that we have. There's lots of excess mill capacity, so we can pretty much double our production from today by bringing in those new mines. So that's and really we've been funding that organically through our own cash flows. So you know we're really trying to maintain a very disciplined approach in our project development.
And with respect to that exploration land, is that something you're also self-funding the development of? And can you tell us what stage you're at with exploring that?
Sure. So really the exploration side of it was a bit of a surprise after we bought it. For us, we didn't realise how little exploration had been done in the belt. Really exploration stopped in 1997. And one of the first things that we did once we recognised the potential, we started to drill. And really, since we bought it, we've doubled the resources in the last 4 years. So, and the cost of that those additional resources has been about $3.45 a tonne. So the drill bit has been very rewarding for us, and I don't expect that that would change going into the future. I think as long as we keep drilling, we'll keep finding more ore and hopefully finding more mines.
Mel, it sounds like your strategy is quite geographically focused. Would you tell us a bit about the short-term and long-term goals for Red River?
Sure. In the short term, I think we love Thalanga being in Queensland. It's a very stable jurisdiction. There's great infrastructure in the Townsville port for us. And also Charters Towers. It's a really good home base for a mining workforce. It's a great town. So it's a great part of the world to be in. So we really love the location of Thalanga. And I suppose, you know, the upside in bringing on additional mines and growing those mines and finding more resources like we have at West 45 and Far West, I think that's really, really important to maximise the value of Thalanga. So really the short-term focus is, you know, continue growing our resources and reserves, bringing on new mines and increasing our mill throughput, because we do have excess capacity. So it's, you know, making the most of that capital infrastructure. And I think in the longer term, you know, barring anything crazy happening in terms of the drill bit, you know, you never know, we might find something really big and crazy. But, you know, without having to bank on that, you know, I also think, you know, the Red River team is, you know, we've worked in businesses where we've operated multiple mines in multiple jurisdictions. But having said that, we do love Australia, and I think, you know, we're always on the lookout for other opportunities in Australia, in base metals, copper and gold. And, you know, I think if we can find something that's valuable that we can add to our portfolio, you know, we'd be prepared to take that opportunity on, and if it suits our skill set as well.
So let's talk about those base metals you're chasing, the lead zinc, the copper gold. Tell us about the outlook for those commodities. I understand you're presenting at the RIU Explorers Conference this week. Seems like a good time to take the pulse on sentiment.
Yeah, look, really looking forward to presenting at the RIU tomorrow. The sentiment has improved. It's progressively, people are getting a bit more confident. So for us, I think, you know, the zinc stockpiles and even lead stockpiles are very, you know, historical lows. I think there's about 4 days worth of consumption on the zinc stockpile on the LME. So they've continued to drop. And, you know, I'm confident that we'll see a price reaction, you know, play out during 2019. And same with copper. And in the last few days, even copper has actually started to improve in price. And I'd expect to see our basket of metals all improve. We also do produce silver and gold as a byproduct credit, and, you know, we've seen some pretty good gold prices in that front as well. But I think in the sort of longer term, you know, the consumption of, you know, copper, lead and zinc is not fading away, and it's sort of improving at around about 2-3% year on year. And these are large mature markets, so 2-3% ends up being a fairly large increase year on year. So I think, you know, the commodity focus that we have is the right one. These are bread and butter metals that everyone consumes on a daily basis, and that's really our focus, is to find and mine more ore in and focus on copper, lead and zinc. And for me also, you know, it's important that, you know, if we do go down the track of, you know, additional zinc mines, that they do come with copper and gold. It's a really good natural hedge to have in the business.
So what are those next big news flows for Red River shareholders?
So really the one we're working on is Far West. We've invested, you know, a decent amount of capital in getting Far West up and running. It's producing development ore. So really the next step is to get Far West into production and start seeing production ore coming out of that in the second half of this year. So we're really looking forward to that. Also getting, you know, Waterloo to an advanced stage where we can start some project works on Waterloo, which I'm hoping will be our third mine. And also the drill bit. So we've got, you know, a fantastic opportunity at Liontown. We've discovered a new ore body there called Liontown East, and that's 400 metres from our existing Liontown deposit, which is our largest deposit. And we've also drilled the gap in between that, which we've found some very high-grade copper and gold mineralisation. So Liontown needs a hell of a lot more drilling. And, you know, the drill bit has been very kind and favourable to us at Liontown. So I'm really looking forward to drilling that. We also did some drilling at Ermine late last year where we had a really interesting intercept. Really looking forward to following that up. And also late last year, we drilled some of the uppers at Far West along strike, and we got some exciting hits there as well. So we need to follow that up as well. So really growing our existing ore bodies and discovering new ones.
Mel Palancian, thank you very much.
Thank you, Danielle.